वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला इंटरपोलेशन मॉड्यूल 6. इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट पीस वाइज पॉलिनोमियल इंटरपोलेशन. इन अर्लियर 3 मॉड्यूल्स और 5 मॉड्यूल्स वी हैव सीन वेरियस टेक्निक्स फॉर पॉलिनोमियल इंटरपोलेशन इन विच वी वर कंसिडरिंग इंटरपोलेटिंग इंटरवल ए बी एंड एन प्लस 1 गिवन डेटा पॉइंट्स आर देयर एंड वी वर ट्राइंग टू approximate the relationship between y and x by means of a polynomial, single polynomial on the entire interval a b, and that polynomial is of degree n. Now, we have seen earlier that the accuracy of this interpolating polynomial depends on how the points are spread and also on the number of points that is involved. If the step size is that influences the accuracy of the formula, and the region of agreement and the accuracy increases as the spread or step size decreases. But when step size and spread decreases, this increases the degree of the polynomial, and when degree of the polynomial increases, the interpolating error becomes much higher towards the endpoints of the interpolating interval. To avoid this conflicting effect on the accuracy of the interpolating polynomial, a technique of piecewise polynomial interpolation is used. So for that, what we do is we consider an interval a b. First we will try to understand what exactly we mean by a piecewise polynomial function. So instead of using polynomial function as interpolating function, we are using piecewise polynomial function as interpolating function. So, understanding what is piecewise polynomial function is first important, and that is what we will do first. So, let a b be any closed interval, and let t be a partition of this interval. Partition means you are getting a set of points in the increasing order starting from a to b, and we are saying the partition is a 0, a equal to a 0 less than a 1 less than a 2, and we continue up to a k equal to b, say. Be a partition of a b which divides the interval, whole interval a b, into k sub intervals. What are these k sub intervals? Which are given by I j, and we are taking closed sub intervals which are having end points as a j minus 1 to a j, and this varies from j equal to 1 to k. So, we get k sub intervals I j. A real valued function f defined on a b, whole of the interval, is said to be piecewise m degree polynomial function if there exists a partition t of a b as mentioned above, such that when f is restricted to sub interval I j, it is a polynomial function. It is a polynomial p j of degree m for all j equal to 1 to k. In order to ensure that f remains well defined on a b, the polynomial functions p j's must be such that at each of the partition points a j, we may call them as knots, p j of a j must be same as p j plus 1 of a j. Otherwise, at that junction point, there will be two definitions of the function, and which is not allowed for a well defined function. Now, what we are going to do is, if m is equal to 1 to 3, then we call this polynomial function as piecewise linear or piecewise quadratic and piecewise cubic polynomial function respectively. So, m degree, that means when we are approximating, when each of the approximating polynomial in the sub intervals p j's are of degree 1, it is linear, piecewise linear polynomial function. If it is degree 2, it is piecewise quadratic polynomial function, and similarly for piecewise cubic polynomial function. Since each of the polynomial functions p j is continuous on the sub interval I j over which it is defined, and since p j's are restricted by condition 1, each piecewise polynomial function is continuous on a b. The condition 1 is nothing but p of p j of a j is same as p j plus 1 of a j. So, that is the condition that we are talking about. So, polynomial function is continuous on a b. However, these functions are not necessarily smooth or differentiable at the knots, that is at the partition points a j, j equal to 1 to k. We will see this by taking one illustration. So, I am giving illustration of piecewise linear, piecewise quadratic and piecewise cubic polynomial. So, I am taking first function as f 1 x, which is given to be equal to, I am defining these functions on closed interval 0 to 3. So, f 1 x and we are taking partition as 0, 1, 2, 3. So, we are taking 3 subintervals, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. And on each of these subintervals, we are defining various polynomials of degree 1, polynomials of degree 2 and polynomials of degree 3. So, in f1x, we are taking these polynomials as 2x plus 3 on 0 to 1, 4x plus 1 on 1 to 2 and 11 minus x on 2 to 3. Note that the partition that we are taking is 0 less than 1 less than 2 less than 3 and I1 will be equal to 0 to 1, I2 equal to 1 to 2, I3 equal to 2 to 3 and p1x is given by 2x plus 3, p2x is given by 4x plus 1 and p3x is given by 11 minus x. And note that p1 1 and p2 1, p1 1 is equal to p2 1, p2 2 is equal to p3 2 and so on. So, both these conditions are satisfied at the internal knots. We take similarly another polynomial function, piecewise polynomial function f2x, where on the interval 0, 1, we define the polynomial as x square plus 2x plus 3 on 0 to 1, then x square plus 4x plus 1 on 1 to 2 and 11 minus x plus x square on 2 to 3. So, and f3x is the piecewise cubic polynomial function where we are defining f3x as x cube minus x square plus 2x plus 3 on 0 to 1, x cube minus x square plus 4x plus 1 on 1 to 2 and 11 minus x plus 3x square minus x cube on 2 to 3. These are all respectively piecewise quadratic and piecewise cubic polynomial functions. Graphs of these functions are given in the following figure and you can see here that in the first illustration f1x, graph of f1x shows that on each of the subintervals the function is linear, it's a straight line and at the knots the values are identical and you can see that at those points derivatives may not exist because there are corners here and left hand and right hand derivative will not match. Similarly, we are taking a quadratic function graph and then piecewise quadratic function graph. So, on each of the subintervals it is a quadratic polynomial or quadratic function. And at the knot the values are same and similarly for cubic function and here you can see that in cubic case we are getting cubic polynomial in each of the subintervals and that is how these polynomial functions can be considered. Now, we see how we are going to use this polynomial function in order to interpolate the relationship between y and x or interpolate data points x I y I on the whole of the interval AB in general. So, suppose we are given that n plus 1 data points x I y I for I equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n where A is equal to x 0 is less than x 1 is less than x n equal to B. I need actually the points to be distinct, but here because we want to have piecewise polynomial interpolation, I want this points to be ordered in the increasing order. We are taking the suffixes in the increasing order. So, are distinct numbers and also suppose that the function f represents the true relationship between x and y just to have a kind of representation of function value y in terms of f x. We are considering f to be true relationship, f may or may not be known. In polynomial interpolation, the true relationship between x and y is approximated by a polynomial of degree n. In piecewise polynomial interpolation, this relationship is approximated by a piecewise m degree polynomial function for some small positive integer m provided m divides n. We are taking m divides n so that we can get intervals properly, k intervals, sub intervals in which we can divide this whole interval AB. To be more precise, suppose n is equal to k dot m, then interval AB can be partitioned like this. So, what we are doing is we are taking partition up to x 0 to x m, then x m to x 2 m, x m to x k m and b. So, that in each of the subintervals we get m data points for at which the function value is known or at which x I y I are known actually. So, in each of the subintervals we have got m nodes and there are such k intervals. Therefore, totally there will be n plus 1 nodes, n nodes and the first starting node. So, that is how it will be. Distribute the nodes will be distributed and on each of the subinterval x j minus 1 comma into m comma x j m, f is approximated by m degree interpolating polynomial over m plus 1 nodes which are given by what x j minus 1 dot m comma xj minus 1 dot m plus 1 up to xjm. So, from j minus 1 dot m suffix to jm. So, total there will be m plus 1 nodes for at which the values of y's are known, and it is they are all contained in the interval ij. For determining this interpolating polynomials, now because it is a small interval, ij is small interval as compared to ab, and we have got the m nodes, m plus 1 nodes already there. So, we can approximate the relationship, this true relationship between on the smaller subinterval polynomial of degree m. So, that is what we are trying to say. So, for determining this interpolating polynomials over the k subintervals, any of the interpolating technique as discussed earlier can be used. So, I can use Lagrange's interpolation method or Newton's divided difference interpolation method, or any of the, if they are equally spaced, we can use even forward or backward difference interpolating formulas and so on and so forth. For example, if we take n equal to 6 and data points xi, yi, I equal to 0, 1 to 6, so n plus 1, that is 7 data points are known. Then taking m is equal to 1, we can interpolate these points by a piecewise linear interpolating function px as follows. So, what we are doing is, we are considering in this case the partition will be what? x0, x1, so same given points will work out as a partition here. And we are taking j equal to 1 to 3 up to 6, ij will be equal to xj minus 1 to xj. So, jth interval, for example, first interval will be x0 to x1, second interval will be x1 to x2 and so on, last interval will be x5 to x6. And then we are taking polynomial p restricted to ij we are considering. So, we are considering this p is the entire piecewise polynomial function, but when it is restricted to ij, it will become a polynomial of degree 1, which is given by in the Lagrange's form as x minus xj upon xj minus 1 minus xj into yj minus 1 plus x minus xj minus 1 upon xj minus 1 into yj. So, this is what your Lagrange form of interpolation, and if you take it as a Newton's divided difference interpolation form, then p restricted to ij and at the value at any point x is given by f of x j minus 1 plus first divided difference over the nodes j minus 1 and j into x minus xj minus 1. So, this is what we get as Newton's form of divided difference interpolation polynomial over that interval. Taking m equal to 2, we can interpolate these points by a piecewise quadratic interpolating function px as follows. So, what we are doing here now, m equal to 2 we are taking. So, the points inside the interval jth interval ij will be x 2 into j minus 1, x 2 into 2 j minus 1 plus 1 and x 2 j will be the second last point. So, there will be 3 nodes there, and using these 3 nodes I am trying to find out a quadratic polynomial using Lagrange's form. I will get this. So, using Lagrange's form, I will get x minus x 2 j minus 1 into x minus x 2 j divided by x 2 j minus 2 minus x 2 j minus 1 x 2 j minus 2 minus x 2 j into y 2 j minus 1 2 into j minus 1. And then similarly, we will get the second term as shown in this, and we can also take the third term. So, second term will be x minus 2 j minus 2 x minus 2 j and x minus 2 j minus 1 minus x 2 j minus 2 in the denominator, x 2 j minus 1 minus x 2 j, and whole ratio is multiplied by y 2 j minus 1, and we will get the third term as x minus 2 j minus 2 into x minus 2 j minus 1 upon x 2 j minus 2 j minus 2 x 2 j minus 2 j minus 1 into y 2 j. So, this is what we get Lagrange form, and if we take the Newton's divided difference form, we will get f of x 2 j 2 into j minus 1 plus f of x 2 into j minus 1 comma 2 j minus 1 into x minus 2 into j minus 1 plus second difference now, f of x 2 j minus 1 comma x 2 j minus 1 comma x 2 j. So, first is x 2 j minus 2 comma x 2 j minus 1 comma x 2 j, and then we take x minus x 2 j minus 2 into x minus x 2 j minus 1. So, this is what we are getting. So, taking m equal to 3, we can interpolate these points by a piecewise cubic interpolating function p x, and that can be done as follows. In this case, the partition T will be of the form x0, x3, x6 and b. So, there will be only two sub intervals, x0 to x3 and x3 to x6. In quadratic case, we had only three sub intervals, x0 to x2, x2 to x4, x4 to x6. And here we have got only two sub intervals. And on this two sub intervals, we approximate f by means of polynomial of degree 3. So, you can take the Lagrange's form of polynomial of degree 3 over the nodes x3j minus 3, 3j minus 2, 3j minus 1 and 3j. So, these are the four nodes in this interval. So, I have to use Lagrange's polynomial function over these nodes on the interval x3j minus 3 to x3j. And you can see that form is given here. Similarly, I can get this by Newton's divided difference also, and that is given by f of x3j minus 3, that is 0th divided difference, plus f of first divided difference 3j minus 3, 3j minus 2 and x minus x 3j minus 3. Then second divided difference will be using f of x3j minus 3, 3j minus 2, 3j minus 1. And into there will be two factors x minus x 3j minus 3 into bracket another bracket x minus x 3j minus 2. So, that is the product of two factors. And the third term will be using all the four data points, we will get the third divided difference. So, f of x 3j minus 3, 3j minus 2, 3j minus 1 and then x 3j and then into x minus x into 3j minus 1, x minus x 3j minus 2, x minus x 3j minus 1. So, this is your third degree polynomial. The above illustration, we have used Lagrange's or Newton's divided difference interpolating polynomial. To see the effect of piecewise polynomial interpolation, we consider the following Runge's example. Now, we take a concrete example for seeing what will be the effect of this piecewise polynomial interpolation. You know that we have used Runge's example earlier, which is 1 upon f(x) equal to 1 upon 1 plus x square. So, I am assuming that the true relationship between y and x is given by f(x) equal to 1 upon 1 plus x square, and we want to approximate this true relationship by piecewise polynomial function. That is what I have to do, and I am taking this function on the interval minus 5 to 5. What I am going to do is I am going to consider the nodes, 7 nodes here. So, what 7 nodes I am going to consider? Minus 5, minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2, 4 and 5. So, there will be 7 nodes I am going to use. So, that I can use linear polynomial function, piecewise polynomial function, piecewise linear function, piecewise quadratic polynomial function or piecewise cubic function. So, this is what I will be trying to do here. So, in order to use Newton's divided difference form of interpolating polynomial, up to third order divided differences are computed in the following table. Now, you have seen that we will use the Newton's divided difference interpolation form, and for that what I need is up to third order divided differences, and therefore, I will consider here the third order divided differences I will compute, and they are computed here, they are shown in the following table. So, first column represents the nodal points, that is minus 5, minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2, 4, 5. Then the second column shows the function values or 0th divided difference. So, value of 1 upon 1 plus x square at these nodal points are given, and they are 0.03846 and so on. So, 1.2 and then finally, we get 0.03846. You can see that the function is symmetric and therefore, the values are symmetrical around that 0 coordinate or 0 point. Then we will take the first order differences. First order differences are taken as value, function value minus the that means f at minus 4 minus f at minus 5 divided by minus 4 minus minus 5, that is plus 1. So, that means I am taking the differences here, divided differences. So, first order divided differences are given in column 1. Similarly, second order divided difference, if I want to take, I have to take the difference of the first order differences and then I have to divide it by minus 2 to minus 5. So, the points like that, and then I will get the second order divided differences, and similarly I will get third order divided differences. Using these divided differences, I am going to now approximate my I'm going to use the piecewise polynomial functions to approximate the true relation, the function f. So, piecewise linear polynomial interpolating function we are going to consider, and for that will our partition will be minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, 0, 2, minus 5, minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2, 4 and 5. So, that is what we are going to get. So, on the interval minus 5 to minus 4, I am going to use 0.03846, that is f x 0 plus f x 0 x 1 into x plus 5. So, because x 0 is x plus 5. So, that is what I am going to use, and similarly I will go on using this value. So, you can see the table, and we are using the first value of the second column and the first value of the third column in the first interval. Then second value and second value, third value and third value, fourth value and fourth value, fifth and sixth. So, that is how we are using those values in that order in order to find out the first degree polynomial functions in the respective sub intervals here. Similarly, I get, so that will be PL, I am determining so linear, so it is PLX, and then I am talking about PQX, that is quadratic polynomial function. So, in quadratic polynomial function, we will be using three nodes at a time. So, I will be considering three nodes at a time given by, you can see here the from the table I am going to use the values. First three nodes, so I will be using 0.03846 from the first column, 0.02036 and 0.01674. So, first values. Then because I am skipping one node here, I am going to skip the second values from each column, and I am going to use third values from each column. Then fourth values will be skipped, and then I will be using fifth values from each column. Fifth values from each column. So, this is fifth value, this is fifth value, and this is fifth value, and that is all. So, these are the three functions I will be getting as I will be getting these functions like this. So, here I will be getting 0.03846 plus 0.02036 into x plus 5, 0.01674 x plus 5 x plus 4 into x plus 4, then 0.2 into 0.4 into x plus 2 plus 0.2 into x plus 2 into x minus 0, and then finally I will get 0.2 minus 0.07059 into x minus 2, 0.01674 into x minus 2 x minus 4 on 2 to 5. So, this is my quadratic piecewise quadratic function, that is approximating f. Then piecewise cubic polynomial interpolating function, which will be approximating these nodes. Here again I will be using the partition as minus 5, 0 and 5, so only 3. So, I am going to skip 2 points in between. So, we will be getting the minus 5, then 0, then the 0 and then 5. So, there will be 2 intervals on minus 5 to 0, 0 to 5, and on these intervals I am going to use cubic polynomial function, and cubic polynomial function will be using what values from the data? We will be using first set of 4 values. So, first values from first column, first value from second column, first value from third column and first value from fourth column, and then I will be using from the last. So, I will be using here at 0. So, because second interval start from 0 to 5, I will be considering this as the first value. So, I will be considering the fourth value from the first column, fourth value from second column, fourth value from third column and fourth value from fifth column. So, that is, we are skipping 2 intermediate values. So, that these values we are going to use in order to find out those polynomial functions. So, the cubic polynomial function, I will be getting it as 0.03846 plus 0.02036 into x plus 5 plus 0.01674 into x plus 5 into x plus 4. See, you can see that first three terms are giving the quadratic polynomial function in the first interval there. And now I am using the third, fourth term, that is 0.01312 into x plus 5 into x plus 4 into x plus 2. So, that gives me a cubic polynomial function on interval minus 5 to 0. And similarly, I can use the other values and get the polynomial function on 0 to 5. So, you can see that it is very systematically we can find out these polynomial functions, piecewise polynomial functions approximating the function value f. Now, to see the effect, you can look at the graph here. What we have done is that we have considered all the approximating polynomial functions, three approximating polynomial functions and original function. All of them are plotted on the same, in the same figure to compare the values. You can see that the black graph, it gives me the original function on the interval minus 5 to 5, 1 upon 1 plus x square. Then I get red graph. Red graph shows me piecewise linear function. So, piecewise linear function will get here between minus 5 to 4, 4 to this, 4 to minus 4 to minus 2, minus 2 to 0, 0 to 2, then 2 to 4 and 4 to 5. So, all those are red straight lines. This is a piecewise linear function. Then I am using piecewise quadratic function, which is green function. So, green is first quadratic, second quadratic, third quadratic, and then that is what we will be getting. So, first is minus 5 to minus 2, second is from minus 2 to plus 2, and third is from 2 to 5. So, that is how I get quadratic polynomial function, and the cubic polynomial function is given between minus 5 to 0 and 0 to 5. So, that is given by the blue line, and you can see that the blue curve, that is cubic polynomial curve, is very close to black curve, that is original curve. So, that means the error will be least. So, note that piecewise cubic interpolating polynomial is quite close to the original function and does not show sudden increase in the error towards the endpoints of the interval of interpolation. We had seen that in earlier numerical experiments that we performed, we saw that if the degree of the polynomial is higher, there will be some sort of very large errors coming towards the end of the interpolating interval. Now, that effect is gone here, and this is the main advantage of piecewise polynomial interpolation. The most commonly used values of, so normally what we do is in piecewise polynomial interpolation, we do not want very large degree of polynomial function, at the same time we do not want very small degree. So, normally people use piecewise cubic polynomial interpolation function, which is very, which gives a very reasonable approximation to the true relationship between x and y. Now, if you look at the algorithm for that, we will have to do some kind of what we can say, we can this algorithm will have to be developed in such a way that we have to calculate k polynomial functions on the k sub intervals, and each k m degree polynomial functions we have to calculate. So, I am considering my input. So, I am considering that there are n data points given to me, x I y I. So, I am taking n as input, then I want that degree of approximating piecewise polynomial function is m. So, I am taking m also as an input, the data points of course, I am taking as input, and these data points we ensure that they are in the increasing order. So, a is equal to x 0 is less than x 1 is less than x n up to b, and then we are taking n equal to k into m and x in a b. So, we ensure that the value, so x is a point at which we want to find out approximate function value f x by a piecewise polynomial function. That is what we want to do. And output we want to consider it as p x, which is a piecewise polynomial function. So, this is the value of mth degree piecewise interpolating polynomial function over the given data point. So, this is the value which estimates value of f x at x, and the values of the coefficient. In order to know this piecewise polynomial function, we need their coefficients. Now, because up to cubic m degree polynomial I am taking, so therefore, I have m plus 1 coefficients will be getting, because they will in m degree polynomial function there will be constant term, term with power of x as 1 and up to power of x as m, and so therefore, there will be m plus 1 coefficients, and in the jth interval this m plus 1 coefficient I am denoting them by a 0 j, a 1 j up to a m j, and these coefficients will try to determine and give it as an output in this. So, these are the, so we are considering the coefficients a 0 j up to a m j for the jth polynomial of degree m over the interval, what interval we are going to take now, x of j minus 1 into m comma x j m. So, for j equal to 1 to k, so there will be k such polynomial functions we will be considering. So, the this algorithm is divided into various groups of steps. So, first is initialization. So, we need anyway, the Newton's divided difference interpolating polynomial up to mth order, and that we have to first compute, then we will compute the polynomial function. So, we are initializing the first zeroth divided difference by original values of the data points yi. So, I am taking f x I equal to y I for I equal to 0 to n for all n plus 1 points. Then I am taking k as n by m, because only m I have taken as input. So, k I have to compute, and I am ensure that m divides n. So, k equal to n by m is an integer, and for j equal to 1 to k. Now, the first coefficient of each of the interpolating polynomials will be f of j minus 1 m value. So, at x j minus 1 into m value. So, f at this value I will be considering. So, the first value will be f of x 0, second value will be f of x m, third value will be f of x 2 m, and like that you go on doing it up to k m. Then we are taking initializing all those p j x's, and p j x's will be nothing but a 0 x's, and then we will be going on adding term by term in order to compute this p j x's. So, p j x is what? P j x is the jth m degree interpolating polynomial, which is part on the interval ij, on the interval ij. So, iterative step is given by which calculates m up to mth order divided differences. So, I am taking I equal to 1 to m and j equal to 1 to n, and then this is simple divided difference interpolation formula. So, that is what we are going to, divided difference formula actually. So, we are using this to compute all these m divided difference, m up to m order divided differences. Then compute all the coefficients. Now, we will be computing all the coefficients, because these coefficients are nothing but the part of the divided difference table. And then, so this is how I am trying to do. So, I am considering a I j I equal to 1 to m. So, I am considering m coefficients for each of the polynomial function j equal to 1 to k. So, I am considering a I j as f of x j minus 1 comma m comma x j minus 1 comma m up to plus 1. And up to I am going to consider x j minus 1 comma m plus I. So, this is the divided difference I am taking. So, you can say I am taking here. So, when I is equal to 1, it will be first difference. I equal to 2 will be second difference, like that. So, it will be continue up to mth order difference, and these are the coefficients a I j. Now, identify interval I r. So, now because we are given x value. Now, x, so f x is to be approximated by piecewise polynomial function. So, what will be the value of piecewise polynomial function? Piecewise polynomial function will be p j x if x lies in the I jth interval. So, in order to find out actual value of p x, what I need to consider is that in which sub-interval x lies. So, that is what first I am identifying. So, if x is less than x 0 or x is greater than x 0, then we say that it is a wrong data and we terminate the algorithm. This is just for completion of the algorithm. And for j equal to 1 to k, I am checking whether x is, because they are all well ordered points. So, if x is not less than to x x m, that means it is greater than x m, and if it is less than x 2 m, it is in the second interval, like that I am doing. So, I am saying if x is less than to x j into m, then take r equal to j. So, in that interval, so r is the interval in which my x lies. So, I am taking that value of r as j and exit the loop. So, we will just identify the sub interval in which x lies, and then I am now trying to find out prx. So, in order to approximate my fx, I am using prx here. Why? Because x is in the rth interval, and prx I can calculate as simple. So, that means we are considering term by term we are adding. So, each term in the polynomial I have to add. So, I am adding it by taking t equal to 1. So, I equal to 1 to 3 up to m. Then I am considering t star this. So, already coefficients are identified there. So, only thing I have to add those multiplication factors, and these multiplication factors are taken into these terms. So, t, the first time I will be getting only one one factor, in the second term I will get two factors, and up to m term I will get m factors. So, that is how I will get prx computed, and then this px will be prx, and all the coefficients I can give as an output. So, it is a very systematic algorithm which we can develop for computing this. Now, we can compute the time complexity of this algorithm. In order to get time complexity of the algorithm, how many divided differences we are computing? We are computing n 0th order differences, n first order differences n minus 1, second order differences n minus m, mth order differences. So when total number of divided differences that we are calculating is sum of all this, and sum of all this will be nothing but n into m plus 1 minus so plus m in minus m square by 2, because that is minus sign, so that I am writing there, divided by 2. So many divided differences are to be computed, and each one of them require 2 subtractions and 1 division, and in addition k comparisons, so that is for computing divided differences, and then we want to find out where, I mean, that x lies. So we have to do k comparisons for that, up to k comparisons, and then m additions and 2m multiplications are required to compute prx. So total number of computations will be given by n into m plus 1 plus m minus m square divided by 2 and 2a plus m and so on. So roughly your time complexity will be given by n into m plus 1 plus m minus m square divided by 2 whole bracket multiplied by 2 additions and capital M multiplication. And just to distinguish the small m and capital M, so capital M is the time required for one multiplication operation, capital A is the time required for one addition or subtraction operation, and capital C is the nothing, or small c is the time required for one comparison. So that is how the time has been calculated. So here, so I will be getting this back, n into m plus 1 plus m minus m square by 2, the small m bracket complete into 2a capital A plus m bracket complete, k into c comparisons we are considering, and m into a plus 2m, and thus if m is small or less than 3, the asymptotic time complexity of this algorithm will be roughly of the order n into m. So this is much smaller as compared to what we were getting, the asymptotic time complexity in the earlier algorithm. As mentioned in the earlier modules, error ex at any point x in the domain of observation ex is given by fx minus px. Now here I have to find out ex minus px, where px is a mth order piecewise interpolating polynomial function. So on each of the intervals, sub intervals, this error will be given by the formula which is already used in the earlier modules. So I am considering, because it is mth degree polynomial over the nodes r minus 1 m, so in the interval r erx I am considering that error value. In the interval r, I am denoting it by erx. So erx will be given by fm plus 1 into zrx. So zrx is nothing but a point, some point in the open interval there, xr minus 1 dot m comma xrm, and so m plus 1th derivative at this point divided by m plus 1 factorial into x minus xr minus 1 m into x minus r minus 1 m plus 1 and so on, x minus rm. So this is what the error is. So this error I am going to call it as ERX. So this is if x lies in that interval. So what will be the maximum error possible? So maximum error will be the maximum of the value of ERX. So therefore, I will be getting EX equal to maximum of ERX 1 less than R less than K. In other words, we are going to get, if I now measurize this function, that means if I find out the upper bound on the whole error, I will be getting 1 upon m plus 1 factorial will be just the constant thing that we are going to multiply. And then I am taking this derivative. So I can take the supremum of all the derivatives in the sub intervals, this, and then multiply by mod of xrm minus xr minus 1m, that means the length of that sub interval, rest to m plus 1, because there are m plus 1 values there. So I will get this multiplied by this. And then this is a measure of or upper bound on ERX, and then I am taking maximum of all such interval errors. So that means ERX. So that means I am taking mod X will be less than to maximum of 1 less than R less than to K, within bracket I will be getting supremum of FM plus 1 X on the sub interval XR minus 1 M comma XRM. And then I am multiplying it by mod of xrm minus xr minus 1 into m whole rest to m plus 1. So that absolute value of whole rest to m plus 1. So this upper bound is relatively small as compared to the upper bound as given in the module 1, because in the upper bound on the module 1 we have given is this interval length is b minus a. Now length of interval b minus a is higher. At the same time, rest to power is also n plus 1. So this value becomes very large in the large interval and higher degree polynomials, and therefore this will be relatively small error will be getting. So I am saying that this upper bound is relatively small as compared to the upper bound as given in the module 1, which is valid for Lagrange or Newton divided difference or Newton forward or backward difference interpolating polynomial. What are the limitations of this piecewise polynomial interpolation? The limitations, as we have seen, that if you take the piecewise polynomial interpolation and if you look back the figure here, then you can see that at the corner points the function is not differentiable. Whereas, when you are approximating the relationship by a single polynomial on the whole interval, that is infinitely differentiable. So, here we are replacing an infinitely differentiable by a piecewise polynomial function which may not be differentiable at the k knots, and that is one of the major drawbacks of this particular method. In order to improve this drawback, there are many techniques being used in the literature, which is not going to be within the scope of this lectures, and therefore, we will be skipping those techniques. But I can say that you can look for Hermite interpolation or spline interpolation techniques, and you can refer to the references given in the advanced reading, additional reading material section. So, you can look for the references for these spline interpolation as well as Hermite interpolation in those references. And that will give you a better idea as to what kind of techniques they use in order to overcome this shortcoming of the piecewise interpolating polynomial, and whether we can have some smoothness included in the piecewise polynomial interpolation. So, that is what we can do. And so, what we will do is, in the summary, what we have seen here in this particular module is that we are approximating the true relationship between x and y by a piecewise polynomial function of degree m. So, we are assuming that on each of the sub intervals we are approximating the polynomial the true relationship f by a polynomial function of degree m. We have seen that in doing this it becomes the certain drawbacks which we saw in the polynomial interpolation on the whole interval are a little bit reduced. Then we also saw the algorithm for finding out such polynomial functions and the approximating a value of the function f x by this polynomial function at any given x. So, we have seen the algorithm for that. We have computed the time complexity for that, and we have seen that the time complexity is somewhat on the lower side, we can say. And then we have also seen the error, and we have seen that error is also going to be little less in the piecewise polynomial interpolating function. And then we have seen that one drawback is that the piecewise polynomial function which approximates the true relationship between x and y is not differentiable at certain points, or it is not smooth, and therefore, cannot be used for any further for numerical differentiation on the interval a b or numerical. So, this cannot be used for numerical differentiation kind of thing. Whereas, the polynomial function, when we are approximating it by polynomial function on the whole interval, because it is differentiable n times different or infinitely differentiable function, we can use it for finding out numerical derivatives when the given data points in the interpolating interval. Thank you.